Hello, welcome to CNN Student News. What a lovely Saturday it is today in Calexico, California. There has been current news that have been ignored for the past month, and it was the kidnapping of the girls in Nigeria. Now here is David Pacman to let you know more about that information of the kidnapping in Nigeria.
In the midst of the corporate news stories of late, the story of 200 missing girls has received pretty little attention compared to other stories. 2 weeks ago, 234 Nigerian girls were abducted, allegedly by the militant Islamist group Boko Haram, from the government girls' secondary school in the Sambisa Forest in Nigeria. The Borno State schools closed 3 weeks ago because of what The Guardian describes as an increasing number of attacks by militants who have killed hundreds of students in the past year. The girls went back to school on one particular day 2 weeks ago because they had a physics exam. On April 14th, their kidnappers broke into the school, killed two guards, loaded the girls into trucks, and drove off. 30 to 50 of the girls are believed to have escaped. The rest of the girls, mostly 16 to 18 years old, are missing. Last week, some of the kidnapped girls' parents came forward to say that Boko Haram, whose name means Western education is a sin, or Western education is forbidden, have threatened to kill them and their daughters. The Nigerian government is doing relatively little to find the girls. If you were to look at the front pages of your preferred American news sites over the last 14 days or so, or tune into your favorite news broadcasts, you'd have maybe seen just a passing reference to the story, or none at all. Over 200 teenage girls stolen, believed sold, maybe raped, maybe some combination, and still American corporate media devoting almost no attention to this, barely a mention on CNN and the LA Times, just at least mentioning it a little bit. Giving more attention to this incident won't necessarily bring the girls back. We don't know what their fate is right now, but we know from experience that when worldwide and particularly American corporate media take stories like this under their wing, so to speak, it really points a very bright light at what goes on within certain organizations, within certain countries, etc. And there would be significant benefit to notifying individuals, to pointing light at what's going on in Nigeria, but it doesn't seem to be.
In the local news, there was a geothermal well that had erupted in Brawley, California. Now here is Daniel to let you know more of that story.
The local geothermal well in Brawley has burst this last month. The plant provided power to Brawley and parts of El Centro and Imperial. The plant production of power was restricted for 2 days. Power was restricted in those areas for a short period of time. Many people were affected by this.
Thank you for that information. This last Thursday, a disaster struck in the Bambooster Banquet at Calexico High School. Here is Manny to tell you more of that story.
Well, whoever took this video clearly does not know how to take a video. Anyways, here we see the great mace passing between our senior jump major Jose Luis and our junior jump major Kim. Alright, so we're just waiting and they're passing the mace. Okay, what a lovely spin. Going really great. Oh, and he hits the tower thingy. And he passes it, and it's a clean pass. Oh, and he hits it too. Oh my gosh, this is not a good day for Calexico. This is officially has cursed Calexico for the next year. It has completely cursed Calexico for the next year. Completely cursed it. 100%. 100% cursed.
Okay. Please stand, all band students. Color guard drill.
Let me see. Drum line. Attention. Drum line. Bridge is getting up. We're still on up, and then he's going to give us first call. Yeah, that was very beautiful. I'm glad that I got to assist this event.
Kim, all the attention.
Can you see the spirit of the people?
Attention.
I could have done it so much better. So much better.
Thank you, Manny. That was a really lovely story. Anyway, we're going to present you a video regarding the Great Depression.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States. My friends, I want to talk for a few minutes with the people of the United States about banking. Talk with the comparatively few who understand the mechanics of banking, but more particularly with the overwhelming majority of you who use banks for making deposits and withdrawing checks. I want to tell you what has been done in the last few days and why it was done and what the next steps are going to be. I recognize that the many proclamations from state capitals and from Washington, the legislation, the treasury regulations and so forth, couched for the most part in banking and legal terms, ought to be explained.
Depression, I am owned and hated by many at the same time. I come in all shapes and sizes. You can ID me. You have 30 seconds. I am an empty wallet. Well, I hope you got the ID me right. Now here is Manny and Daniel with some furry felines.
Alright, number 10.
Alright.
Okay. Oh, look at it. Throwing the toys.
What is it gonna do now?
I don't know. Ah, look, you can say it's got the wolf genes. Okay.
Well, it's Big Mama in the house.
Big Mama in the house indeed, Daniel. Big Mama. Ooh, when she tries. Oh, scatter! Okay. Scatter! Scatter!
All over the place, man.
All over the place. What do we see here now? Okay.
Just what?
Oh, look at this.
Well.
Okay. You can say that this cat has some, what do we call that term? That non-violent term. That cat's got guts. It's just pure guts. And,
this is such a nice massage.
Yes, I bet this cat has some sort of major or... Yeah. This cat has a major in being a masseuse.
Right there.
That's a spot. Oh. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Let's get over.
That was bad.
Well, I tell you what, right there, you gotta learn that from someone.
Yeah, it's not something you see every day.
I mean, they ain't gonna do downs on, I'll tell you that.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how cats
what are you
can
doing?
Do this. I'm pretty sure it's a very domesticated cat.
Okay, it's like, well, this reminds me of Garfield.
Yeah, look at it, trying to eat its food.
Mm-hmm. Nope, not there.
Nope. We got a selfish cat here.
Maybe go over there?
Nope. It's his food.
No, my turf son.
Nope, it's his food.
Mm-hmm. You see his sign of attack?
Do you know what they're eating?
I have no idea.
They look like cat food. Look, just look how selfish that cat is. It's just like a fat boy on Christmas.
Fat boy?
Yes, a fat boy with a lot of chocolate on Christmas. It's like, who can I have some? No, it's my chocolate, mine. Because, you know, we all get chocolate
all right, next
on
video.
Christmas.
What is he doing?
What is he doing?
Filing cabinet.
Okay.
All right. Trying to sort your files.
Transfer for, okay.
Oh,
what is
it taking out?
So it's like, hello there. I totally wasn't doing anything inappropriate.
I didn't do nothing in there.
Okay, apparently this thing's...
There's a fly.
Oh, no,
that's
bee.
Creepy.
It's a bee.
That's creepy.
Oh, predator mode. And we see a Garfield. Yes, we see a Garfield.
It's too fat.
Yeah, it's
trying
to get...
It's just too fat.
And
Come on. You're almost there.
Come on, you can do it.
Squeeze in. He's giving birth to you.
Come on. All right, so we just saw a door give birth to Garfield. Lovely. Alright, I guess this is it. Really fun video.
Thank you guys, that was so punny. I don't think you can send any more of this punishment. Now, this is all for today. Thank you guys for watching and seeing in Student News.